Hey everyone, the Artificial Trainer here. Welcome in, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking WanFun camera controls. This is the best camera control model that I've seen come out so far. And it does straight image to video, so you don't have to have a full video to input into it. And it can also do a wide variety of paths. Okay, so I'm going to use ArtOfficial Studio for this today, which basically sets up all your AI tools in one environment. But if you just want it, the workflows and the models, you can go to my Patreon. The workflow is here, and then the model links are all in this .sh file. If you need some help reading it, you can just copy paste this whole thing into ChatGPT and it should be able to parse it for you. Okay, so if you want to use Artificial Studio, if you don't already have access to the beta, comment in the description below or head to Discord and send me a DM or message me on Patreon. I just need your GitHub username and I'll add you to the beta. Head over to the model downloader and you'll see WanFun Camera Control. If you're using Artificial Studio, just check that and hit download selected models. I already have them downloaded, so it just completes instantly, but it'll start downloading if you need them. And then head over to App Links and go to ComfyUI. If you're using Artificial Studio, you can search for camera here and you'll find a pre-made workflow for you already imported. Just click on that. Obviously, if you're just following along without Artificial Studio, just grab the JSON from a Patreon and drag it in. All right, so let's choose a image here. All right, so I have this cool image of this astronaut. I'm going to resize it. Let's just try 512 by 512. And then the first thing we're going to do is zoom in. Oh, and sorry, if you are not using Artificial Studio, just make sure you're adjusting all the paths. Artificial Studio puts everything in the spot it expects it to be, and then all the workflows are based on those paths. But obviously, if you're downloading the models on your own, you need to adjust the model loader, the VAE loader, the clip, and I think that should be it. And Artificial Studio does give you Triton and Sage Attention. Triton gives you Torch Compile right out of the box, so that's why I'm using them. All right, so I think we're all set up. We just need to put in our prompt, so the camera zooms in on an astronaut walking on. All right, so it's gonna zoom in and you can adjust the frames as well. If you don't wanna do 81 frames, it's probably gonna break down if you go over 81 frames, but you can do anything less than it. So let's hit enter and go. All right, so this is pretty fast. So remember, this is a 1.3B model, so we are probably gonna get some breakdown. The one thing that I was a little bit disappointed with this model is you don't really get much movement. I think that this is going to be better for like scenery shots or, you know, things that you're not expecting movement in other than the camera movement. For subjects and things like that, this isn't that great. All right, so let's see if I have something that's more like scenery. So I have this image of a futuristic city. So let's see if I... let's go tilt right. And so you can see the preview of the motion here. So the purple is 0 frames and then the red is the end. So 81 frames in this case. So it starts at the purple and then we were doing zoom in. So obviously it pushes in. All right, so for tilt right, we're gonna see something slightly different. So for this one, it's sort of like a pan, but the camera is also rotating to the right. Oh, and then let's make sure that I change the prompt. So the camera pans right in a futuristic city. All right, yeah, so as expected, works much better in scenes where you're kind of not expecting motion. And you can see my original image wasn't great quality, so that's probably why we didn't get great quality in the output, but it tilts right perfectly. It follows the motion path perfectly. And one other feature we can play with here is how much movement we get from the camera. So there is a speed control on this create camera control poses. It's 0.1 by default. I've been able to turn it up to 0.2, sometimes 0.3, and still get pretty decent results. So you'll see our, so if we run this at 0.1, we'll see the camera control. So that's what it looks like at 0.1. And then just to show you, I'm going to turn it up to 0.6 and we'll see what we get. So you can see it's much more of a full circle when we turn it up to 0.6. Now, when I've turned it up to 0.6, the results have been poor, but that's just to show you, you can increase the amount of motion the camera makes, but if you increase it too much, you're gonna get bad results. So there's a balance there. Let's try one last one. Let's try a clockwise roll. I haven't tried this yet, so we'll see how it goes. I'm just gonna say the camera moves with the blonde woman as the subject. And so this really strongly overwrites the prompt. So like, even if I said zooms in, the camera most likely wouldn't zoom in. So really cool generation there. Again, this is the 1.3B model. Hopefully they're working on a 14B model to release as well. That'll give us, you know, help us maintain likeness a little bit better. That's kind of the first downfall you get with 1.3B models, is that you lose the likeness of the character pretty quickly. All right, so that is it for this video. Have fun with this one. There's a bunch of camera movements out of the box. And you can even, if you're technical enough, you can even import Blender movements or Blender camera motion paths, which is another really cool feature of this model. All right, so if you want to try out Artificial Studio, send me a message, get in touch with me. I'll give you access to the beta. If you want to see more of my content, make sure you hit subscribe. That's the biggest way to help me get more content out there. Follow my other socials to get a sneak peek of what I'm working on ahead of time. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again in the next video.